What's up, everyone, and welcome back to the Daily Pfav. This is episode 71 for Friday, June 8th, 2018, and the time here is 4:18 on the East Coast. It has been a very sad week in the news this week regarding suicides. Kate Spade earlier in the week and this morning waking up to the news that Anthony Bourdain took his own life in France. And although we don't know these people, we feel a connection to them somehow if you're a fan of their work. And nonetheless, you feel the impact of that sudden loss, that tragic news that they are no longer with us. So where do we go from here? And I don't mean each of us in our own day-to-day life, because we all still woke up and went to work this morning. But how do we address this suicide epidemic, that's on the rise in our country? What more can we do? What other resources can be created and offered to people that need help? How many more hotlines do we need? More and more insurances are offering solutions. What other medications can be created, and how many more sessions with a therapist do we need to lower this national suicide rate that has been on the climb since the mid-90s? And my answer isn't going to be very popular, because I don't know that there's anything more that can be done. People that don't want to be saved can't be saved. There are two different types of suicidal thoughts. People who make up their mind and just do it, and people who think it, display those cries for help, and get saved. I think it comes down to a choice by the person. People have a right to die. And as a medical professional with a 20-year career, I have experienced this firsthand for two decades. And I, like many of you, know someone that has committed suicide, and in that tragic aftermath, we all point a finger of blame somewhere that help should have been available. And why didn't you see the signs or even call someone? But what about when it's a superstar A-list celebrity that not only has the money, but every resource available to them? Because if you live in a world of superstars, and if you've ever worked with celebrities or ever read about it online, you know that when they do a concert or do a movie, they have a rider, they have a part of their contract where they have needs and demands, and their team and those staffs of people will move heaven and earth to get a special case of water that only comes from one place in the world if someone requests it. It comes down to a choice that person made. They didn't care about the resources available to them, and they may not have wanted help, or maybe the help didn't work. No one is going to convince me that suddenly overnight, Anthony Bourdain went mad and could no longer think for himself and didn't know what he was doing. It comes down to a choice, and that choice was that he wanted his life to end on this day, at this time, and in this place. It didn't matter what resources were available. What mattered was that he reached out for help to allow those resources to work, because they do work. We hear and read stories every day of the passerby that finds someone about to jump off of a bridge and starts talking or singing to them, and it changes that person's mind. But it all comes down to a choice that person has to make. And when they're no longer capable of making safe and sound choices, they have to be hospitalized by family or friends. And family and friends of those that take their own life are absolutely destroyed and haunted for the rest of their days. But the hashtag stop suicide aren't going to help. It comes down to a choice that person makes. And although to me suicide is a very selfish and hurtful thing to family and friends and coworkers, it still comes down to their choice. And trust me when I tell you that there are people that pick an age and say they are going no further. There are people that say, if these test results come back positive, I'm not going through treatment. Or people, they have had enough treatment and stop. It comes down to a choice. It comes down to what they want, regardless of the impact it has on their loved ones. And to me, that's very sad and tragic. You can throw every resource at someone, and you can only force it if they're an apparent threat to themselves. And those that have selected the moment or the age are going to do it, and you may never know they're thinking of it. And they may never display any signs that they have chosen their end date. This is why it's so important each and every day to be your very best to everyone, to be as kind and loving as you can to everyone, because you don't know what people are thinking and where their minds are. And maybe something you do or say changes a thought you never know they may have had. You don't realize how powerful a smile is or a common act of kindness can be. I don't like suicide. I, like many of you, have had very dark days, and I know there are probably many more to come, but I've seen the beauty in this world and the beauty in people. And to me, that's the message that needs to get out to anyone in any kind of mental distress. Beauty exists everywhere. Sometimes you have to find it, but oftentimes it's right in front of you. But it still comes down to a choice. A choice you may be powerless to stop, and one you may never know about. And the sadness in all of this, not everyone can make the same choices we make with how we manage our dark days and tragic times. All we can do is do our very best to be kind and love one another the best way that we can.